Today we're going to learn how to perform the Eustachian Tube Function Test. So in order to perform this test, we have a special function in our tympanometer, which is called as ETF function. So select the ETF test. We're going to be performing on the right ear. So first, you need to get a baseline tympanogram. So all you need to do is press start here. So we're getting a baseline tympanogram. We have already placed the probe in the ear. And as you can note here, the sweep rate is 50 decapascals per second, which is slow, but it's supposed to be good to get a good tympanogram. So once you get the baseline tympanogram, the next, what the instrument does is it creates a positive 400 decapascal pressure in the patient's ear. So once the pressure is established, you have the patient drink some water. Okay, next you're going to get a second temp. Just press start here. So by creating a positive pressure in the ear canal and having the patient drink some water, it's going to create a negative middle ear pressure. As you can see here, the peak is now shifted to the negative side. And now the instrument creates a negative middle ear pressure, which is minus 400 decapascals. So once the pressure is maintained in the ear canal, have the patient drink some water. So repeat it again. Get the third baseline audiogram. Sorry, tympanogram. So as you can see now, the peak is shifted to the positive side. By creating a negative middle ear pressure and having the patient drink some water, it shifts the middle ear pressure to the positive side. So you have three peaks. So here you can see the shift in the middle ear pressure from the baseline to the second temp and the third temp. If you see a change of around 15 to 20 decapascals, or which is an indication that the Eustachian tube is functioning normally.